sense of hoping.
Because when you quit hoping, you're dead, that's why. And let me tell you this, mister, I could have told him, Anders. Bert and Sarah Davis broke are 7 million times richer than you are right now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I may not be a fine character, but I'm eating.
Sure, you're eating, but they're alive.
Well, what am I? Dead?
So close to it, it'd take a pretty experienced coroner to say yes or no. Bert and Sarah have known what it's like to love somebody. They got each other and their kids and hope. You got your land, but you're sour and you're lonesome and you got Fred Gubbins. I know who wins for my money, and it's no photo finish either.
Never mind the lecture. Where are they?
What do you care? They're down by the tent. Them and 20 other families holding a meeting.
A meeting? How do you mean, holding a meeting?
I mean, holding a meeting.
Well, what about?
Well, it'd be pretty hard for you to understand, being like you are about people. They gotta move on to someplace, see? There's prunes to be picked here and oranges to crate there and a cotton crop someplace else, maybe. They figured out if they all went to the same place, they'd be competing with each other. So they're down there deciding who goes where. They'll all starve, most likely. But in this way, they're spreading the starvation out over a couple of states and not bringing it on each other.
I'm going down there.
What are you gonna do, crow over them? Just you dare, Bill Anders, and I'll... Well, you just wait and see what I'll do.
Matt and Ned Sullivan, you're down for Santa Clara Valley.
Okay, chances are as good there as anywheres.
Davis.
Yes, sir?
Before you make definite plans, I've got a little proposition that I'd like to put up to you.
Why, sure, Mr. Anders. Was it just for me personally,
or... All of you here and as many others as want to put in with you.
Step in here beside me, Mr. Anders, so everybody can hear.
I had a talk with those government men today. That's why I went down, you know, when they were making the assay. I thought all this land around here was open for homesteading. They said it is.
Yes, we know, but you got to prove up your claim inside of 2 years.
That's right, you got to work the land. And while you're doing it, how are you going to eat? Where are you going to get the tools or the water either?
Yeah, that's what we'd like to know.
I've got the water. There's a table of it under my land, enough to feed a couple of thousand acres. I've never tapped it, never developed my own acreage. I want to do that. Now, here's my deal. I've got the water and a little capital. I'll put up the money to buy tools, plows, a tractor, seed for the first crop.
What's the catch? What do you want from us?
Yeah, what have we got to do?
Dig the irrigation ditches for my land and yours. Help me get my acreage planted first. Just your labor. That's all I want from you. It's a cinch to irrigate this land. Working together, we could get the whole valley under cultivation by next spring.
Great. Hold on a minute, Mr. Anders. It sounds good, all right, but there's some details I don't get. We can't work our land till yours is all planted and watered.
Yeah, what about that, Mr. Anders?
That's right. I get help on my acreage first in return for what I loan to start things moving.
Well, how'll we eat meantime? We got families.
Yeah, how about that?
I'd take care of that. I haven't got much ready cash. We'd have to spread it out and make every cent count, but you wouldn't starve.
What guarantee have we got that when your work's done, we get our end?
Only my word.
A mighty flimsy guarantee to stake all that work on.
Yes. Supposing something was to happen to you, or you changed your mind after your work's done, where'd we be?
Sounds like the Garden of Eden without no snakes, but it sure is chancy.
You people don't trust anybody, do you? I see I made a bad guess. Forget it.
I don't mistrust you, Mr. Anders. I'll put in with you.
No, I had a bad idea. Forget it.
Bill, don't say that. Wait a minute, everybody. You can't say no to him. It cost him plenty to ask the lot of you to be neighbors and partners of his. He had to come out of a shell with barnacles on it. He could go on living all right the way he was. But what about you? Here's your chance to have homes again and farms and raise your kids decent. Oh, you can't turn it down. I never knew there were people living the way you've had to live till I met the Davises. I know what's the matter. You think it's too good to be true. You've taken such a beating today, and for the past 5 years, you figure there's a catch to everything. Well, there's no catch to this. It's a straight offer from a straight guy. Oh, can't you see? He's given you a chance for life.
You're right, Maisie. I'll go in with you, Mr. Anders. Your word's good enough bond for me.
Well, same here, Anders.
How many says yes to Mr. Anders? Speak out. Come on, speak up!
We better stop the others that are leaving already. There'll be a lot of them who want to stay.
Sure, I need them all.